He's all alone. He misses his mother, probably. He's out there somewhere. Reconnecting him with his mother is a real challenge. They live in the deep water, very far offshore. So if we go out there and we find striped dolphins, we have to say, okay, stay here, I'll be right back. We have to run back here and get Marcos, put a transmitter on him, and by the time we get out there, they've moved 100 miles. Between the shoreline here and where far at sea, where the striped dolphin are large groups of bottlenose dolphins. So if he were to be released right here, he would not get past the bottlenose dolphin. They're liable to beat him up and bully him. This material is just like a dolphin skin that he likes to rub on it. Makes him feel like he's in the company of other dolphins. After all, he's in isolation. See how he's rubbing on her? But he's getting healthier every day, much stronger than when he was brought in 3 months ago. So there's two steps to this. First is getting his health back and getting him strong. The second is moving into the rehabilitation phase, giving him live fish. Marcos, this is for you.
Ahora mismo, el operativo que tenemos con Marco, necesitamos dos cosas. Necesitamos medio humano para hacer los turnos, para poder atender a Marco. Y necesitamos medios económicos pues, para poder financiar toda la infraestructura que estamos construyendo para Marcos, para darle más posibilidades de profundidad, más posibilidades de que pueda capturar pescado vivo.
We're trying to help the people with the nets now. We are going to tackle with the boat, and we're going to try and change the nets to change the old one to a new one. That's what they've told us. And we're getting our suits on because it's cold.
Además de eso, necesitamos financiar también, pues, el que Marcos pueda tener un transmisor para poder hacer un seguimiento con nuestra libertad y observar si tiene problemas o no para poderle atender. Cuando tratemos de reintroducirlo mar adentro, cerca de una población de delfín del listado o delfines comunes, que también podría ser, una de las posibilidades de hacer el traslado hasta esos puntos podría ser una piscina que serían remorcadas por una embarcación.
There's only three things that could happen. His immune system goes down, which could happen here in, after all, he's in captivity. He is in captivity here. And captivity is very boring, and dolphins get very bored, and especially if they're in isolation. So his immune system could drop, and he could die. That's a possibility. Scenario two is that he becomes healthy, and that we find his striped dolphin community and release him successfully into the wild. That's not possible. Scenario number three is to create a sanctuary for him if he's going to stay in captivity. And so the people here at Promar get in the water day and night just to keep him active so his immune system doesn't drop, keep him interested in something, moving around. When he is healed and he's strong, and we move him to deeper water for the rehabilitation process, that contact will stop with people. This is the world's cutest dolphin.